Welcome to the Transform Our World podcast with Ed Silvoso. Ecclesia, everyone, every day, everywhere.
What is an ecclesia? In its most embryonic expression, listen carefully, is the gathering of at least two believers around the manifest presence of Jesus with authority to bind and to release for God's will to be done in their sphere of influence. That's the very heart of prayer. We pray according to the will of God, and the will of God is done. The basis for that is in the scriptures. That gives us reassurance. Matthew 18, verses 18 through 20 says, "Truly I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall have been loose in heaven. Again, I say to you that if two of you agree on earth about anything that they may ask, it shall be done for them by my Father who is in heaven. For where two or three have gathered in my name, I am there in their midst." What the promise that anything we ask in the name of Jesus, the Father will do it. But the question is, why is it that we don't get 100% of our prayers answered, as Jesus promised? And what is it that we bind and we release on earth, but it doesn't remain bound and released? Why? Look at this passage. There are three steps that you are required to take, and God will deliver three promises. Step number one, when two or three gather in His name, Jesus comes. What a promise. When anything they ask, they pray for on earth, is done by the Father in heaven. And the third step is that when they bind and release, they are empowered to bind and to release. So look at that. Three actions that we take, three promises that God delivers. If we call on the name of the Lord, He will come. Do you realize that now when you go to prayer, the Lord says, "I will come." Where is He coming from? From the right hand of the Father. And what is He doing there? He has been interceding for you. So why is it that we don't get our prayers answered? Well, I asked the Lord that, and He says, "Ed, you rush too quickly to pray, to request things, but you don't honor Jesus who is coming to be with you." If the Queen of England were to walk through the front door, what would you do? Oh, she will get my undivided attention. I will, you know, greet her, "Whatever you desire, Your Majesty." And God reminded me, "My son is greater than the Queen of England." So now that changed my life. When I begin to pray with my wife, with a prayer partner, we take time welcoming the Lord Jesus. You know, we use 2 Chronicles 7:14. "If my people who are called by my name humble themselves first and then pray." You see, I was rushing to prayer. No, take time to welcome the Lord Jesus. And then you seek His face and you turn from your wicked ways. Then and only then, God says, "I will hear from heaven, I will forgive their sins, and I will heal the land." Pay attention to that passage. We call on the name of the Lord, and at that moment we come under His Lordship. We humble ourselves, we adore, we worship Him. And then we begin to pray, and we seek His face first, and we turn from our own ways. You see, when we do that, listen carefully, the mind of Christ begins to impregnate your mind. Like if the Queen of England comes and she asks for a cup of tea, you will run to get it. If you welcome Jesus and you listen to Him, you will begin to think His thoughts. And at that moment, we are renewed in the spirit of our mind, not just on the soul side of our mind, but on the spirit side, what comes from God. And then we begin to pray the prayers that Jesus has been praying at the right hand of the Father. And when we do that, 100% of those prayers are answered. And we are able to bear fruit, much fruit, and fruit that remains. Look what Jesus said in John 15, verse 7. "If you abide in me," remember, He comes, He manifests Himself in your prayer meeting, And my words, the ones that I'm talking to you, my words abide in you. Now you know how to pray. And now you ask, and whatever you wish, it will be done for you. Awesome, awesome. You see, the deeper meaning of praying is not talking, it's abiding. It's basking in His presence. It's sensing His presence. Take time as you go to prayer to celebrate the presence of Jesus and to listen to Him. He may speak to you from a passage in the Bible. He may speak to you through your prayer partner. He may speak to you through a thought that pops up, but you will know that it comes from God. And look at this verse. Truly I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall have been loosed in heaven. So that we will be binding on earth what the Father and the Son already bound in heaven. That's different than what we were doing before. Because look at the picture. The Father is the principal figure. Jesus is in our midst when we gather for prayer. He's like a mirror. We look to Jesus and we see what the Father is doing. And then we are able to see what the Father is doing through the presence of Jesus. And now we are able to pray prayers that the Father will answer. And at that moment, we are given authority to bind and to release, because the God of peace will soon crush Satan under our feet. There is a spiritual warfare going on, and God is giving us the authority to bind and to release, but we shouldn't rush there. First, we welcome Jesus. We bow before Him. We abide in His words. We pray the prayers that He guides us to pray. The Father answers that, and now we discover what the Father has already bound in heaven or loose in heaven, and we do it here. And God crushes Satan, all forms of evil, under our feet. Whose feet? The Ecclesia. Who is the head of the Ecclesia? Jesus. Where is Jesus? At the right hand of the Father. But now the Holy Spirit comes and reveals Himself. Look at this promise. He, the Holy Spirit, will guide you. Oh, this is so key in prayer. Will guide you into all truth. For He will not speak on His own initiative, but whatever He hears, He will speak, and He will disclose it to you what is to come. What will He reveal to you? Listen carefully. What the Holy Spirit hears the Father and the Son binding and loosing. Doesn't this change prayer and makes it more dynamic? And now we are asking God for the anointing, because the anointing is what makes the difference. Gideon without the anointing was a coward. Gideon with the anointing became a mighty man of God. The anointing is the breath of God, is the presence of God in your prayer meeting that revives everything in you. Samuel without the anointing was a miraculous baby. But with the anointing, he became the greatest prophet in Israel. David, without the anointing, was a lowly shepherd. With the anointing, a mighty and prolific king. Oh, my friend, listen to the Holy Spirit. This is how Paul put it. For in Him we live, in Him we move, in Him we exist. That changes prayer, right? That is like being a fish in the water. When you gather now, celebrate the presence of Jesus. Exalt the presence of Jesus. Realize you live in Him, you move in Him, you exist in Him. And now you abide in His words, because He will speak to you, either by the written word, through your prayer partner, through a sensation, but it will be a two-way street. And that's why I pray that you will emulate Mary. When Mary didn't know how, but the angel was announcing will come to pass, she asked, how can this be? And the angel said, the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and He will deposit something in you. And I pray that right now, the Holy Spirit comes upon you and teaches you how to pray. In Jesus' name, cry with me, Holy Spirit, baptize me. Yes, let's do it.
Thank you for listening to today's edition of the Transform Our World podcast with Ed Silvoso. Ecclesia, everyone, every day, everywhere. We invite you to make your own home in Ecclesia, a place where the presence and power of the Lord Jesus dwells every day. Then visit us at transformourworld.org or Ecclesia Everywhere on Facebook to join a massive movement of believers who are changing our world for the better, because it really is God's time for you, your family, your neighborhood, and nation.